You can install the vCenter Server appliance on an ESXi host using the command line installer. You can use the command line installer to perform a silent unattended installation of a vCenter Server appliance, perform a batch installation of multiple instances of the vCenter Server appliance concurrently. Before you begin the vCenter Server appliance deployment, ensure that your environment meets the system requirements listed in the vCenter Server installation and setup guide. The CLI deployment process involves the following steps. Download the vCenter Server installer on a network virtual machine or physical server from which you want to perform the deployment. Prepare a JSON configuration file with the deployment information. Run the vcsa deploy install command to initiate the deployment. Verify whether the installation is successful. To download the vCenter Server installer file, go to the VMware Downloads page. The ISO file is available under VMware vSphere. Once the file is downloaded, double-click the vCenter Server Appliance ISO file. Open the vcsa CLI Installer Templates folder to prepare the JSON file. There are several templates to address different deployment options. Before you run the CLI installer, you must specify values to the configuration parameters in the JSON template specific for your deployment. The embedded vcsa on ESXi template contains the minimum configuration parameters required for the deployment of a vCenter Server appliance on an ESXi host. The template has various sections for different configuration parameters. Read through the instructions carefully and enter the values specific to your environment. Similarly, the embedded vcsa on VC template contains the minimum configuration parameters to deploy the vcsa appliance on the inventory of a vCenter Server instance. The VC section contains the configuration parameters that describe the target ESXi host or DRS cluster from the vCenter Server inventory. The rest of the sections contain common configuration parameters. The embedded vcsa replication on ESXi contains the minimum configuration parameters required to deploy the vCSA appliance as a replication partner to another embedded vCenter server on an ESXi host. The template is similar to the ESXi template, but with additional parameters specific to replication partner. Similarly, the embedded vCSA replication on VC template contains the minimum configuration parameters required to deploy the vCSA appliance replication partner to another vCenter Server appliance on a vCenter Server instance. The vCSA with cluster on ESXi template contains the minimum configuration parameters required to deploy a vCenter Server appliance with a single node vSAN and or vCenter Lifecycle Manager cluster on an ESXi host. The template is similar to the ESXi template, except for an additional section specific to cluster configurations. This template is available only from vCenter Server version 7.0 U2 onwards. For detailed information about the parameters and acceptable values in each of the templates, see the Deployment Configuration Parameters section in the vCenter Installation and Setup Guide. In this example, we will deploy the vCSA on an ESXi host without a vSAN or vLCM cluster. Therefore, we will use the embedded vCSA on ESXi template. To update the template, copy the template from the installer to a local folder on your machine. We have already added the necessary values. As shown in this template, the values must be enclosed within quotes. To deploy multiple instances of vCenter Server appliances concurrently in batch mode, use the static IP addresses for each vCenter Server instance. Create a template for each vCenter Server instance. In this demo, we will deploy a single vCSA server appliance. Therefore, we will specify DHCP instead and remove all the parameters as per the instructions here. Now that we have our JSON file ready, we will proceed with the deployment. Launch the command prompt and navigate to the vCSA CLI installer and the Win32 directory. Enter the vCSA deploy install command to initiate the deployment and accept the EULA to accept the license agreement, which is mandatory. If the CEIP enabled parameter in the JSON file is set to true, enter the acknowledged CEIP argument. Optionally, you can add other command arguments as needed for your deployment. For the complete list of command arguments, See the syntax of the CLI deployment command section in the vCenter installation and setup guide. And finally, enter the path to the JSON template we just created. To deploy multiple instances of vCenter server appliances concurrently in batch mode, specify the path to the directory where you saved all the templates. In this example, we are deploying a single instance of the vCenter server appliance. Therefore, we will proceed with this command. We will press enter to proceed with the deployment. The deployment process begins. Enter 1 to accept the thumbprint. Depending upon your network connection, it may take around 30 minutes for the deployment to complete. When the deployment successfully completes, the vCenter server login information displays. Note down this information. You can verify whether the installation is successful by logging into the vCenter server interface. Open a supported browser and enter the IP address of the vCenter server appliance. Enter the login credentials. The vCenter client opens and connects to the vCenter server appliance, allowing you to view and manage your inventory. This concludes the demo about command line installation of the vCenter server appliance. For more information about installing the vCenter server, see vCenter server installation and setup guide at docs.vmware.com.